Hello everyone, I am bringing a new addition to my YouTube channel, and that is going to be every Sunday. I am going to have just a sit down chat, so having a chat with Stevie about a specific topic. And if there are any topics that you are personally wanting to talk about or hear me talk about, then leave it in the comments below. So I actually opened up a little bit about this on my Instagram story, but I wanted to talk a little bit further about it and to just really express how I've been feeling lately. So as many of you know, I decided to cut my hair. Just giving you guys the full effect. But I decided to do this literally the day before my hair appointment. And I decided that I just wanted to make a change and to kind of prove a point. And for many of you, this might seem a little bit out of the ordinary. You're probably going to be thinking, it's just hair. Why is it that big of a deal? But for the longest time, I was told, being someone who has done pageants for the past 4 years, and I have definitely been in the entertainment world, I have always been told, like, if you want to be successful, if you want to win a state pageant, you have to have long hair. And you have to look a certain way, and you have to fit this standard that society has put on beauty. And for the longest time, I genuinely believed that. I believed that I needed to have long hair, I needed to look a certain way, I needed to fit this ideal part that people were telling me I needed to be in order to be successful in what I was doing. And it wasn't until recently that I was like, why am I letting the opinion of others, or genuinely the opinion of people as a whole, what we think beauty is, dictate what I actually want to do and what actually makes me feel beautiful? And so I decided to prove a point, not only to myself, but to the people around me, that I was going to cut my hair. And although that seems really small, and in the big scheme of things, it's like, it's just hair, like, it'll grow if you want it to. And it's really about the bigger message here and how it genuinely made me feel and how free it allowed me to be in my own life, that I am now setting a standard of beauty for myself. And I'm not trying to achieve someone else's standard of beauty, but I'm trying to achieve my own. And I knew that in this form that I am right now, like, I feel so confident and I feel so myself more than I ever have, that I knew that this was the right decision. And that's what I want other people to see as well, that it does not matter the color of your hair, the length of your hair, the color of your skin, what you go by, what size you are, none of that matters. And none of that is determining your standard, your own personal standard of beauty. The most beautiful people are the people that are completely authentically themselves in whatever aspect that might look or be. And that is what I fully realized, is I do not have to look a certain way in order to feel beautiful. And I hope that if this will reach anyone, it doesn't mean go cut your hair, because some other people's standard of beauty might be that they do have long, luscious hair and that's what they want, and that is perfectly okay. Remember that you are living this life for you and you're not living it for anyone else, and that being true to yourself is going to be the best way to achieve that standard of beauty, because it's your own. And it's hard when we live in a time where social media is so prominent in all of our lives, that we see and hear and we look at these women or men or whoever they might be, that they are looking a certain way, and we feel like that we need to be like that too. okay, well, they're successful and they look like this, so I need to be like this. Okay, well, my ex-boyfriend told me that he prefers blondes with long hair, so I need to be like that. Or my basketball coach says that I need to look this certain way in order to be successful in this specific field. Not it. I challenge you all, and I am challenging myself to really connect with who we are, to ask ourselves, am I doing this for myself, or am I doing this for the validation that I'm going to get from someone else? What is it going to be? Is it going to be that you're choosing you and you only, or are you choosing the opinion of others? Go ahead and ask yourself that question. And to tie this with my specific message with healthy life, healthy mind, I always struggled a lot with comparing myself on a physical level, that I had to look a certain way and that I had to work out 7 days a week so that I can look like this ideal version of myself that I strive to look like. And although that's good on a certain level, I was doing it for the wrong reasons. I wasn't working out and taking care of my body because I wanted to feel a certain way, because I wanted to feel good for myself. I was doing it so that I would look a certain way, so that people on the outside would see me and I would have that validated opinion from others. It wasn't until I did the work and I realized that you cannot do anything. You cannot physically change yourself for the validation of someone else. You need to physically change yourself so that you feel powerful, so you feel beautiful, that you feel strong. Some ways that you can do this are, one, starting out with that sit-down conversation with yourself. Sometimes it is very difficult to have an inner conversation. We tend to run away from that most times. We tend to run away from our problems. We find distractions so we don't have to genuinely think about what we need to fix. So that is the first step, is really making sure that you have that conversation with yourself. What are my goals? Why am I doing this? And to make sure that you are connected with the fact that you are doing it for you and for no one else. Another step is to take your plan into action. There are a lot of times that I say I'm going to do something, but it never becomes accomplished because, again, I start running away from it. I don't want to come in contact with myself and to know that I am going to put my plan into action and I'm going to make these changes so that I am going to be a genuinely happier person for me. So make sure that you get your plan into action. For me, I knew that I wasn't happy with the way I was training, that I was training to look a certain way instead of feel a certain way. And I was also changing things about me that I knew I was only doing for other people. So my plan to action was to shift my mindset with working out and to change my mindset into being, I want to feel a certain way. I want to feel good. I want to mentally be able to walk into a workout and to feel like I am here for that reason, and to also cut my hair. Ways that I really have those inner conversations without literally talking to myself out loud, even though I do that a lot in the car, and I bet a lot of you can relate. For a while I thought I was crazy, but then I was like, this is definitely more normal than I thought. So having those inner conversations, but also journaling. That is something I found very therapeutic and was a way for me to put my thoughts down on paper. And sometimes, if you guys are any way in or shape or form like me, I will write in third person. So I will write as if I'm writing a letter to myself. Another way, and something I found very helpful, is I started removing those people on social media that were not benefiting me or helping me grow into the person that I wanted to become. And that doesn't mean that you need to go unfollow everyone or that you need to personally have a digital detox, even though I definitely recommend that as well. just making sure that the people you are following are influential people in your life and that are bettering you to become a version of yourself that you want to be. Don't follow those people that you're constantly comparing yourself to. And that doesn't mean that those people are negative or that they're doing anything wrong. It just means that they're not benefiting you or benefiting you in your life at this moment, and that you need to take a step away from that, and you need to be able to get on social media if that's something that is a part of your day, and that you find those people encouraging and uplifting and that are going to help you achieve your goals. I'm going to go ahead and end the video here though for my Sunday chat with Stevie, just being able to talk to you guys about being authentically yourself. It is something that I'm so passionate about and that I want to continue to talk about and advocate for, because I know right now more than ever with the way our generation and society is growing is that there is a lot of pressure to be this ideal person, and there has been a standard set. And I know that there are many people right now breaking that standard and breaking the mold of that people have set on beauty. And I'm so glad that we're able to come together and do that. But I also think that there is a lot of work to be done, and it is so much easier said than done. And I want to be able to provide you guys with the tools that have helped me in my own personal life. And so if any of you are thinking about cutting your hair, this was your sign. And if not, you're beautiful anyways. I wanted to start these Sunday chats just so that I can discuss these problems that I'm dealing with, that people can get on my Instagram or my YouTube and they can immediately relate and know that what they feel is completely valid and it's also completely normal. I oftentimes glorify the positive aspects of my life, and I don't share these real and authentic moments of, I also struggle with comparison. I struggle every day that I have to fit a certain mold, and it's something that I am so working on and striving for. And I thought there was no better way that we can also work together and that we're in this together, that I am also in the exact same boat and that so many other people are. And just because they're not talking about it online does not mean that offline they're not feeling it. I hope that these are helpful for anyone that's watching and that can relate to. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure to like and subscribe. And if you want to leave a comment below of any topics that you might want to hear about or that we can talk about together, let me know. But I will see you guys here in about 3 days for another workout video. Bye.